I always tell people, so I just hold the brush and God paints it.
Absolutely. You know? So if you already say that it's supposed to have a higher force at work,
yes, absolutely.
That allows you to become an astonishing painter. But do you believe there's a deeper calling for you? Meaning, what would you want your spectators to understand about your craft? What is the message that you're going to put forth?
Basically, it's recognized. I got a poem called Alpha King in America. And it's basically just recognizing the greatness that we have in ourselves. And basically, whatever you do, it can be painting, it can be whatever you're doing. And just embrace that and just take it to the next level as much as you can. So I think that the arts has kind of called me. If I can do something else, you know, I sometimes ask God, so why you got me doing this right here?
Right.
Because it's a struggle that you put all the effort and energy to. But, you know, when you look at my resume, looking at my pedigree, things that I've done, it's all that struggle that leads to this right here. So when my wife once said to me, she said, you know, if you give it up, you can have it all. So the whole thing is that I give her one aspect to get the whole thing. But it's only God, I give God all the glory. I take no glory.
You said your wife said that?
Yes, my wife
said
that. Yes.
What causes your creative juices to flow? When you sit at home, what gives you that strength, that power to just create?
It's basically life. You know, I'm really inspired by my kids. Probably like the third best artist in my family, in my household. My little daughter, she's 4 years old. She's amazing as an artist. And I get inspiration from my kids. As a matter of fact, my son is actually 3.5 years old. So I started painting when he was born, right before he was born. So it's like, I'm just trying to create a legacy for my children and everything like that. Another way I get inspired is by being a street vendor, being on 34th Street. That's what I call myself, the American. 34th Street is painting outside for the people, so the people are multicultural. So my whole thing is taking that energy and taking it back to my parents. So that always just gives me this.
Okay, you're correct. Has this been a considerable amount of time in Harlem? Let's say you're representing
some of your paintings. Yes, actually, it's through. Other than Brooklyn, Harlem is my favorite barrel too. You know? So it's like definitely taking the history of the Harlem Renaissance era, you know, thanks to Hughes and being influenced me as a poet. So I definitely want to put Harlem back on the map. Just acknowledge Harlem and the history of Harlem and everything like that. So this is the black capital right here. So, you know, with the gentrification that's going on, I say I want to go harness back and just kind of just pay respect to that right there.
What is it about 34th Street, Herald Square, that basically became the mecca of your art?
Very good question. When I first got started, actually being a poet, I wanted to get a place in New York City that I could kind of like have my stamp. So when I came to 34th Street, it's all the iconic buildings, like the Empire State Building, the Macy's Building, Madison Square Garden, so all the iconic places there. So I was like, no, if I want to make my mark, I got to make my mark in a place. I didn't want to use 42nd Street because I thought it was commercialized. So I called it Herald Square, and began everything right there. So now it's like an evolution. So when I say I go from one corner to the next one, it's like it was a poetry. And then I got discovered as a model by Jamel Shabazz. And then I started doing the playwriting. Then I became an artist. So it became like a full circle as far as doing that. So it's like 34th Street is like very, very important to me.
Which genre of artistry do you feel most comparable to your personality or your being as a whole? Is it singing? Is it writing? Painting? Modeling? I mean, you do everything. So which one is closest to you?
Well, I say the anchor of everything is writing. And I say writing because writing, you know, if you're an actor, you can write a play, you know. Writing was something I did that I wrote to other people's paintings. So writing is like, I think it's the anchor to everything right there. But I enjoy every craft that I'm in. So as I was preparing for the show, so when I started doing the writing, I was like stuck in the writing mode. I said, okay, now it's time to paint. I got into the painting mode. I said, now it's time to perform. So I got into the performance mode. So it's embracing all the characteristics, but what happens, everything leads to the next thing. So it's like a tree with branches, though. But at the bottom of the tree, I would say writing is the number one thing as far as like the anchor.
Perfect.
This right here, this is like what I call my masterpiece right here, because I am a man. It speaks so many different ways as far as like being a man, but this whole thing was actually taken back from the sanitation workers in 1968. It was also the last speech that Martin Luther King gave before he got murdered. So this is very historic. It's something that's close to my heart, and it speaks to me right now. It spoke to me. It just speaks to me right now as far as like I am a man. So it's very important. Right? So that's our piece.
I am a man, fighting for my rights. As I hold up this picket sign during this 1968 sanitation demonstration, I'm a family man, just trying to survive. But I'm tired. I'm so tired of working under these unsanitary conditions, leading to my decision to walk off my job more than 50 days ago. We demand that you listen. Listen to our union's collective voices and start giving us better choices. So stop. Treat us like we're less than human by working in this unhuman environment of poor safety measures while being mistreated and financially defeated. So pay me like the other man. Even though I ain't coming. Even though I am black. But I am still equal man. We demand dignity and respect. Plus higher wages than a measly $1.60 to $1.90 per hour. We stand behind our union power, fighting to be unrejected and respected. We demand that you stop treating us like we were prison slaves by being overworked and grossly underpaid. So as we stand here with this I am a man sign. We are a sign of the times, fighting for our labor movement rights, to be treated fairly and right. And this is the genesis of our plan. For you to pay us. And to treat each and every one of us like a man. Because I am a man.